Hello from Brighton Palace Pier. For our first ever visit, there's two roller coaster credits. There's a bunch of flat rides, including a Zamperla air race over there, which I'm excited for. We have the wristbands, £30 for one of these, all day rides, unlimited rides. So, yeah, let's have a couple rides and suppose we'll start off with this Zamperla Looper, which I've not heard a good thing about. It's turbo. But you know what I'm like, I have an open mind because I tend to like rides that people hate. So, yeah, there's a clone of this in South, I think it's a direct clone, no. But there's a Zamperla looping coaster in Southport. And I don't think that's bad, to be honest with you. So, yeah. Queue's not too bad. Let's give it a go. And this is what our first ride is going to be. Plus two in Brighton, starting with turbo. Yeah, hopefully it's not too rough. I've heard it is. So we will just have to see, unlike the one in Southport, the unload and offload are in different places. And that's caused this baggage hold to have to be in place, like you have to drop your stuff there before going on. Not the best baggage hold, but there's no other way of doing it really. Because yeah, you get off there and you have to come round and get your stuff. Yeah, here comes turbo. It's got a nice train. Alright then, we have just done turbo, pinfire looper, and yeah, we did back row, which I enjoy the back row. It's got a really good first drop, but I love the first drop. You come right out of your seat, proper ejector, and yeah, you literally feel like you're going to fall out. And, yeah, not many rides make me go wild nowadays, but yeah. It was rougher than roller coaster at Southport. It did have some dodgy profiling. It can have a few neck and shoulder rattles and hurt here and there, but it's nothing long lasting. And overall, it's just fun. Like, there's a bit of pain here and there, but it's what it is. We'll be giving Turbo another go in a bit. I'm glad we got the credit. What did you think of Turbo?
It was alright.
Yeah. Yeah, some dodgy profiling. Looks like they've got scaffolding as like a catwalk for the lift hill, which just, I don't know, makes it even more dodgy, but I don't know. It's cool. And yeah, I don't know. Yes, it has the odd rattle. But yeah, I love this drop on the back. Look at that. See the ejector. I bet that loops a lot of fun on the back as well. On the front, sorry. But yeah, there we go. It's just the helixes really that, you know, you just get thrown into them. No smooth transitioning or anything. But yeah, anyways, up next is the Crazy Mouse. Unless we end up doing the waltzer next, because my parents are on there now. In the car, in the mouse behind this one, the Crazy Mouse. So yeah, there we go. And it's a good spinner, I assume it's Revachon. You know, it's a better than average one because it has one of them little air time hills there on the last set of drops. So there we have it. Crazy Mouse. There we go. And they're off. And they start spinning. It would have been nice if the car were facing us as it was going past, like the car. Here it goes, just chance for another. No, nice one. Can't be. There we go. There we go. And there's Crazy Mouse. We'll be heading on, unless we do waltzes first, as I said. But yeah, there we go. Creds take priority in places like these. Because yeah, you get waltzes everywhere, but I'd be excited to give the waltz a go. And here we go, oh, on the waltzes. That's the best bit of spin we've had. All cycle, hey, here we go. Here we go, gets going a little bit, this one. Hey, I like it. Spin. Hey. There we go. There we go. Think we're going to do crazy? Yeah, yeah. I'm Margate. Hey. I think that's what you meant actually. Yeah, the Margate ones. Do check out my vlog from Margate. At the time of recording, it's been up a few hours. Got uploaded today, so yeah. Cheeky promo. No card it do- right! Unless I decide to. I think that's a thing of the past.
Solid waltzes. Not the best. Not the worst. Nowhere near the worst. And yeah, I've not done a ride like this for a long time. Forgot the actual name, but yeah. Luna Park, did it used to be at Luna Park? That's cool. Looking forward to giving it a go. Shame I can't film on this one. Probably best though, anyway, obviously. But yeah, there we go. You get some good views up there, but who knows. I think this year has proven that a GoPro investment is needed. Because yeah, like, we don't always visit parks that allow them, but yeah, for times like when we do, yeah, it'd be ideal to have them, right? But yeah, let's go on this cool flat. It does go quicker than this. Copyright, but Booster is at to close. We sat on the ride. And yeah, we had to get off before it even started. Apparently it's because of the platform. Yeah, they moved that manually, like they pushed it in and then pulled it out. Yeah, obviously for people to get on and off it. And yeah, they pull it away when the ride's in motion, obviously, so you don't like scrape your feet on the floor. But yeah, that's done manually, and I assume it's meant to be done electrically. And
Yeah, automatically.
Like,
the ride before we came
I thought
on.
That at first.
Yeah, the ride before we went on the Yatta bus.
But I thought, reminds me of Big Dipper's transfer track, the way they were pushing it in and pulling it, and yeah. Like, I they were cool how they were doing it manual, but it's obviously not meant to be that way, and well, there it is. That's how they were doing it, and it's not how they're supposed to be doing it. It's supposed to go itself. So yeah, we're going to pick up the second cred over here now. Crazy Mouse. And yeah, exciting. There we go on Crazy Mouse. Obviously nothing special because it's the standard layout spinning Wild Mouse, but solid, a lot of fun. Those little airtime hills before the final turn into the brake run always make those rides. Some of them don't have them, which is a shame. But what we did spot up there, and yeah, keep an eye out if you come and you're a geek, behind this fence, just a quick look through the hole while there is one. There is a turbo train in bits there, so that's kind of cool to see. There we go. Do you saw ride parts? I would buy those. It's dark ride time. Horror Hotel. This has a pretty cool facade, to be honest. Looks decent, so excited to give it a go. Being pretty low throughput. But yeah, it's the park's ghost train. And yeah, I just love a ghost train and a dark ride. And yeah, see how it goes. And we're finally on the House of Horrors. Pretty spooky. Wow. Wow, yeah. It's creepy that. The noises. That. Here we go. Got a minor drop coming up here. Here we go. Ah. Oh. Smooth with sharp brakes. Tell you what though, this ride should have double the amount of cars it has. The gaps between each car, honestly, should have so much more, and it'd make get people on it so much quicker as well. Oh, hello sir. Ah, that's a cool effect, can't lie. Here we go. Oh. And this.
Here we go. This is the outside bit of the dark ride, the light bit of the dark ride. We're not much going on. Let's head back inside. I quite like this. Good seeing her. Good effects. Yeah. Wow. Hey. There we go. Oh no, I think there's one of, yeah, there we go. I just saw that. Like one of them things where they hang strings down and it like. I like them effects where they make the people jump out like that. There we go. Don't think that's part of the ghost train, but it's cool. Hey. Wow. Work in trouble. Hey. Oh. Here it is. Is this the end or just another outside section? It's the end. There we go. Really like that a lot. We're back at the end of the pier as Turbo has reopened. It's going to be one of our last rides. But yeah, hopefully we get further than just sitting on it this time. So we actually go up there. Oh, it's called Booster, innit? When we were about to ride this earlier on though, yeah, the staff, very friendly, and they make sure, like, they ask you if you've got anything in your pockets and encourage you, tell you to empty them pretty much. I'd already emptied mine, because yeah, it's common sense really on a ride like this. Like, empty your pockets, don't take anything loose on there. And yeah, but they make sure you do that anyway, so yeah, there we go. It's actually working now. It didn't have to be done manual. It's like Grand National's transfer track now. That's done automatically, isn't it? But yeah, there we go. Let's go on Booster, not Turbo. Unfortunately, I don't think we're going to get time for another ride on Turbo, but we got the cred, we had a back row ride, and I enjoyed it. So that's all that matters for now. Time for what's probably going to be the last ride of the day. It's an air race, a Zamperla air race, and it's called Air Race. Done the one at Drayton Manor, enjoyed it if I remember rightly. That was over 3 years ago now, so yeah, we'll see how this one compares. And then, yeah, there's obviously some rides that we've missed today. Just not had loads of time really for it, but that's fine. Done all the majors, done all the credits, done all the thrilling flats, so yeah. It's been an enjoyable visit to Brighton for today. And here I am, 5 hours away from where the vlog was filmed, over a month after it was filmed, finally doing the outro, ready to upload it in a week's time or so. So if you have been following the channel and its socials over the summer, you'll have obviously seen that we went to a lot of places in the summer and filmed a lot of vlogs, videos, had a great time at a lot of different places. But away from the parks and away from having fun and a good time, I was busy. And that means that time that I could spend editing these videos that I'd filmed was pretty short. Don't tend to have much time to edit anymore. Just a lot of commitments really, obviously family work, and not long after this video was filmed, college. So I only managed to get one video out every week, and it used to be Saturday and now it's Friday. Oh, that's when I try to get them out anyway. And obviously I was filming more than one video a week at a park, and as I said, when I get back I can't edit them all at once, if that makes sense. So I only managed to get one out a week, and like, I kept filming more videos, and like, that caused for a massive backlog of content to put out there. And videos like this and the Oktoberfest Fort Park vlog from last week, the Margate vlog, they all went up like a month or so after they were filmed almost, and well, this one is over a month after it was filmed, and so is the Sea Life vlog. Like, yeah, obviously filmed two vlogs in one day in Brighton, so check out the Sea Life vlog if you haven't already, because that was obviously last week's video if this one doesn't come out sooner. So yeah, just thought I'd clear that up really. I hate having vlogs like just waiting around. I want them uploaded as soon as they're filmed. Like 2021, I used to upload vlogs like the day after or even the night they were filmed, and yeah, obviously I haven't been able to do that this summer, but who knows, maybe those days will return. But this summer, it's been a busy one in and outside of the parks, so, and that's obviously continued into September and it's now October. I'd also like to say, like, this is the last vlog that was filmed in the summer. Like I say, filmed a lot of videos, went to a lot of places for the first time, including Brighton Pier, which is in this video. So if you've watched any, and there'll be some that have watched all of the vlogs over the summer, thank you very much. Been to some cool places, made some cool memories, and it's been great to share them, and I hope you've enjoyed watching them. So yeah, that's the end of this summer backlog, finally. Apart from these two, I didn't film anything in September at all, so that's obviously helped catch up a bit. Obviously went to parks, went to Blackpool and Thorpe a few times. Don't think I went anywhere else in September, but the only vlog that's waiting now, which will be the next one after this, went to Walton Towers on the 1st of October, so yeah, didn't film anything in September at all apart from Brighton, and yeah, like, went almost a month without filming anything. Uploaded some of my videos and obviously caught up a bit with a backlog, so the Alton Towers vlog will only be a few weeks out of date instead of about 4 or 5. But yeah, I thought I'd clear that up, just hop in and give a little update for the regular viewers. I don't think the non-regular viewers will still be watching at this point. That's explained the kind of upload schedule, which I hope has come across as being quite organised, like it being every week. Recently changed to the Friday 6 o'clock instead of Saturday at 12 o'clock. But yeah, there was a video pretty much at the same time every week, once a week. Unfortunately, only once a week, and like I say, some of the videos were out of date. The only vlogs I can really think of now that I'm gonna film, and like, this is all that I know that's definitely like pretty much confirmed now, there could be more. There's the obviously the Alton Towers one. This weekend we're heading to Fort Park Fright Nights, which obviously is just my favourite event that takes place in a UK theme park, so looking forward to that. We'll film a vlog from that. And then there's Blackpool Late Night Riding on the 29th, so I'll vlog that probably. There's fireworks as well. And then that brings us up to where the other parks close, and then it's just Pleasure Beach every weekend until that closes on, I think it's the 27th of November, so might film a few videos here and there on one of the winter weekends, but like I say, we'll see. That's all there is that I can think of right now. I thought I'd kind of give you a bit of a what's coming sort of update. Feel like I should have made that a separate video because it's probably gone on for about 5 minutes. I do apologise for that, but there we go. Like, I wanted to clear it up. And yeah, like making a separate video of it would have messed with the upload schedule even more. So back to what you clicked on this video for, Brighton Pier. We left you just before our ride on Air Race. We enjoyed Air Race. They faffed a bit getting people on and off, I think, in my opinion. The ride was stopped for too long, and yeah, there was just a lot of faff, like, just get people on it, get the restraints and seatbelts in, and just get the ride going, and then afterwards, get everyone off. Like, they unlocked everyone's seatbelts one by one, and like, I swear, you could literally do it yourself, but they told you not to, if I remember rightly, but yeah, is what it is. After that, Turbo was walk-on, so we had one final ride, and we got the front row, and my dad stayed off and filmed that ride, so yeah, if you've not seen that footage on the top of like me talking already, here it is. I enjoyed it. Can't even remember which row I preferred now. I think I prefer the back. Like, Turbo's drop on the back, the first drop, is incredible. It takes you out your seat fully, and yeah, like, that's what I like in a coaster. Whether it's a Pinfari looper with dodgy profiling or not, but I like it. But Brighton Beer as a whole, as well as Turbo, it had the spinning mouse, enjoyed that, the waltzer, the air race. I really like the ghost train. That should have a lot more cars, which I did mention when I was on the ride. That queue was longer than what it could be if they had more cars. But it's a nice place, it has a nice atmosphere, it's busy, or it was when we went there. Good stuff as well, all friendly. Just good vibes. But yeah, that's it pretty much. That's all from summer 2022 and on this channel. Feels weird saying that in October when it's chucking it down. But that's the way it is, like, away from the parks. I have been busy, I've not had loads of time to edit and that, on top of other commitments and staying well rested and all that stuff. So I'm proud I've managed to keep it to one a week at the least, to be honest. But there we go. I really hope you've enjoyed this video and all the videos from this summer. There is more to come, obviously. Alton Towers next week is next week's video. There's Thorpe and Pleasure Beach and who knows, probably something else that hasn't been planned yet. We will see. But I'm rambling as always, so thank you very much for watching. Check out the screen to see more. I'll see you next week in my vlog from Alton Towers.